OAuth 2.0 allows a user to grant a consumer site access to certain private resources that are stored on a service provider site. Imagine if someone wanted to borrow your car, but you didn't want to hand over your only key. What if you give them a specialty-made valet key that doesn't allow your car to drive more than a mile or two? Or what if you could make a special key that wouldn't open the trunk? Well, another blocked access to your radio settings. Regardless of what restrictions each magic key imposed, wouldn't it be nice to customize access to your car for each borrower, with a custom key they could keep, and the ability to revoke any keys accessed remotely, all while keeping your regular key, that unlocks everything, safe in your possession? Ultimately, OAuth exists to give one site access to consume pre-approved data points from a separate site, all without remotely exposing your ID. How OAuth 2.0 works. I saw the most delicious donut in the window of a new local bakery, Consume. So I went inside and demanded, "I must have that donut." Olaf the baker said, "Sure, that will be $30. $30 for one donut? Must be delicious. I reached for my wallet, but he yelled, no, no donut for you." I asked why. He said he only accepts bank transfers. So he handed me a note with his name, Olaf, on it. "Tell him Olaf sent you." His name was already on the note, so I don't know what the point of saying that was, but okay. I drove an hour and a half to my bank, Service Pro, and handed the note to my favorite teller. I told her, "Olaf sent me." With a look that said, "Thanks, but I can read," she took my note, asked for my ID, and asked me how much money was okay to give him from my account. I told her $30. She did some scribbling and handed me another note. This one had a bunch of crazy numbers on it. I guess how did I keep track of the notes at this place? I rushed out of there, starving, and soon I was back standing in front of Olaf with this new shiny note extended. He took it, looked it over, and said, "Okay, I'll be back." I thought he was getting my donut. But after a few minutes, I started to get suspicious. So I asked the guy behind the counter, "Where's Olaf?" He said he went to get money. "What do you mean?" "He took your official note to your bank." Huh. So Olaf took the note that the bank gave me and went back to the bank to get money out of my account. Since he had the shiny note the bank gave him, the bank knew he was the guy I was talking about, and because I spoke with the bank first, they knew to only give him $30. Soon enough, Olaf walked back in and handed over that donut. I could see the shiny note was in his back pocket. Between bites, I had to ask, "Olaf, do you always sell donuts this way?" No, the first version was much more complicated and less flexible. Huh. While walking back to my car, I was caught up thinking about the process I just went through. Think about it. I was able to let Olaf take $30 directly out of my bank account without having to give him any of my account information. And I didn't have to worry that he'd be able to take out too much money because I already told the bank what he could have. And the bank knew he was the right guy because he had the crazy numbered note that they had certified me to give out. Sure, I would rather hand him $30 from my pocket, but now that he had that shiny note, I could just tell the bank to let him take $30 every week. I could just show up at the bakery without having to go back to the bank anymore. I could even order the donut by phone if I wanted to. Of course, I'd never do that. The donut was disgusting. I wonder if this approach has broader applications. He mentioned this was his second approach, so I guess you could call it OAuth 2.0.